Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh. I welcome you to this session in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology. Up to this session we have covered DNA replication, DNA repair, transcription and translation in eukaryotes. Today we are going to discuss about post-translational modifications in eukaryotes. So what are the post-translational modifications in eukaryotes? These processes are categorized as they are reversible or they may be irreversible also. So under reversible, there are certain mechanisms like formation of disulfide bridges, glycosylation, phosphorylation, acetylation, N-acetylation and ADP ribosylation. These processes or these reactions will occur to the protein will result in post-translational modifications, but those will be reversible. And under irreversible category, there are proteolysis of the proteins, maybe ubiquitination also, lysine hydroxylation, proline hydroxylation, which happens in collagen, then methylation. These are the reactions which will occur on amino acids in a protein, and that will be irreversible post-translational modification. Coming to the first one, that is proteolytic cleavage. Proteolytic cleavage is basically the process of breaking the peptide bonds between amino acids in protein, and this happens before the final maturation of the protein. Protein will undergo proteolytic processing. There are specific enzymes which carry out proteolysis, like proteases and peptidases, and with the help of these proteolytic enzymes the protein can also be cleaved as a result of intracellular processing of misfolded proteins. So for example, it is conversion of pre-pro to pro and proinsulin to insulin. So the activation of the insulin occurs due to proteolytic cleavage, and this is the irreversible post-translational modification. Coming to the next type of post-translational modification, that is modification of amino acids. Activation of clotting factor, there is gamma carboxylation of glutamic acid under the influence of vitamin K, and the residues of prothrombin are activated, right? So this gamma carboxylation is a modification of amino acid. Then there is hydroxylation of proline and lysine in collagen with the help of vitamin C, right? This is also irreversible type. Then phosphorylation of hydroxyl group of serine, threonine and tyrosine by kinases. There is phosphorylation of hydroxyl group like glycogen phosphorylase and certain other enzymes also. So phosphorylation and dephosphorylation of hydroxyl groups of these enzymes will activate or deactivate these enzymes, and that will regulate the metabolic processes which are happening in the body under different metabolisms like carbohydrate, lipids, protein metabolism, right? So the enzyme needs to be activated or deactivated depending on the need. So that will happen through phosphorylation, and that is reversible type. Co-translational glycosylation, and in this carbohydrates are attached to serine or threonine residues through O-glycosidic linkage, and to asparagine or glutamine residues mostly through N-glycosidic linkages. So here the carbohydrate moieties are added to protein structure. You can take an example like there are isoforms of a same enzyme, and in those isoforms only different carbohydrate moiety are forming isoforms. So maybe the same reaction, it is getting catalyzed by different isoforms. Though isoforms are coded by the same genetic locus and isoenzymes are coded by different genetic locus. So the isoforms are just because of different glycosylation moiety getting added to the protein structure of enzyme. Okay, so this is co-translational glycosylation. Then there is formation of disulfide bond. This is a reversible type. So the intrachain and interchain disulfide bond formation is also a process which results in post-translation modification, and that is catalyzed by enzyme disulfide isomerase. The disulfide bond formation prevents unfolding of proteins and holds together different polypeptide chains. Like there are disulfide bonds in insulin and immunoglobulins, or maybe a part of polypeptide chain like ribonuclease has intra and interchange disulfide bonds. Then there is acetylation and methylation of lysine residues of histones. This is also a reversible type of post-translation modification. They modulate transcriptional activity of chromatin. एसिलेटेशन विल इंक्रीज द ट्रांसक्रिप्शन बिकॉज जीन्स आर स्विच्ड ऑन एंड डी एसिलेशन रिप्रेसेस ट्रांसक्रिप्शन जीन्स आर स्विच्ड ऑफ दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन रेगुलेशन ऑफ ट्रांसक्रिप्शन द एसिटिलेशन एंड डी एसिटिलेशन ऑफ हिस्टोन्स और द लाइसिन रेसिड्यूज ऑफ हिस्टोन एंड दिस इज अ टाइप ऑफ पोस्ट ट्रांसलेशनल मॉडिफिकेशन दिस इज ऑफ रिवर्सिबल टाइप देन देर आर मेनी प्रोटीन्स आर मॉडिफाइड एट देयर सी टर्मिनस बाय प्रेनिलेशन नियर अ सिस्टीन रेसिड्यू इन द कंसेंसस सिक्वेंस एंड वॉट इज प्रेनिलेशन इज इट इज द एडिशन ऑफ 15 फार्नेसिल ग्रुप और 20 कार्बन जेरेनिल ग्रुप टू द एक्सेप्टर प्रोटीन एंड फॉलोइंग प्रेनिलेशन The carboxyl group of the cysteine is methylated with S-adenosyl methionine. And one such protein that undergoes the type of modification is the proto-oncogene RAS. The proto-oncogene RAS is the example of protein which gets modified because of prenylation near a cysteine residue of the consensus sequence. The statin drugs reduce the synthesis of farnesyl pyrophosphate and thus reduced extent of inflammatory events. So these are the post-translational modifications in eukaryotes. Yeah, this is the literature which you can refer for further reading on this topic. And thank you so much for watching the video. Please subscribe to the channel. Please like and share the video. Thank you so much.